Come on, come on. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, good morning. Good morning. Good morning, good morning. Come on, y'all. Come on in. Come on in with Thanksgiving. Come on in with praise. Come on in with the hearts. Come on, hit the buttons. Let's go. Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to the Everyday Until Dynamic Devotion and Prayer. Everyday Until. Everyday Until. Welcome in. Welcome in. Praise the Lord this morning. Welcome into the Everyday Dynamic Devotion and Prayer. This is what we're doing every morning. We enter in to His courts for Thanksgiving. We enter in with praise. So I want you to enter in this morning. Welcome this morning. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go this morning. Come on, come on, y'all. Today, remember that we come in with our hearts. We come in with our thumbs up. We come in giving Him glory, giving Him praise. We enter in to His courts with thanksgiving. We come in with praise. That's what we do every morning. We put in our city and our state that we're watching, we're calling from. We do that every morning because not only is it encouraging, but we actually believing, there's a spiritual connection there. We're believing that if there's one righteous in the state, we're believing for ambassadors in all 50 states. We're believing for somebody that's going to be eventually in all city that the ambassador will be monitoring, making sure, encouraging, and making sure that we're doing this. We want to get as many people praying at one time as we possibly can. And so we do it every morning. We have taken all of our videos, guys. We have been archiving all of these videos, and we have placed them on our YouTube, Amazing Church YouTube, so you can go back and listen to other ones. We're going to give it its own YouTube channel here in a little bit, and then you'll be able to access that at any point and any time. We're going to put them all up there. It's going to be incredible. I'm telling you, I'm excited about it. I've been telling you that this is coming. We're working on that now because we believe that this is necessary, y'all. This is necessary. Every day until dynamic devotion and prayer. We call it dynamic devotion because you will participate. Please like, comment, share, and tag. Please like, comment, share, and tag. Now, in speaking of liking, commenting, sharing, tagging, and for those of you that are on the call, texting and tweeting, those of you that are on IG that you're sharing, let's make sure that we let everybody know that this is what we're doing, that it's a part of what we believe God wants to do. And so we've been doing 8 for 8 before we enter into the 8th month. 8 for 8 before we enter into the 8th month. We're hitting 8 different regions, and we're tagging, liking, commenting, sharing, tagging somebody in these states, tweeting, texting, sharing, getting someone from these states that we know to participate in this dynamic devotion and prayer this morning. So the region that we're hitting this morning, y'all, is the mountain region. That's New Mexico, Arizona, Colorado, Utah, Nevada, Wyoming, Idaho, Montana. All right, those are the states, y'all. Those are the states. All right, mountain region, New Mexico, Arizona, Colorado, Utah, Nevada, Wyoming, Idaho, Montana, in those cities. All right, Colorado, I'm calling on my son, Nathan Carter. I'm calling on my homie, Brian, Pierre. Listen, come on, there are people that you know in these places. Like, comment, share, and tag them and get them on the call. All right, every morning, 8 a.m. Central Standard Time, we're here every day until Dynamic Devotion. We'll get inspiration. The inspiration is coming out of the inspired Word of God. That's why we call it the inspiration. And then your motivation is, what is this word saying in order for me to perform the application? You'll get the app. So I'll have your inspiration and we'll have your motivation, but you're responsible for the app to apply the Word of God today to live life a better way. That's how we do it. We are believing that we're going to apply the Word of God today. A principle that is there will apply to our lives today so we can live life a better way. We do this, y'all, every morning because we believe that breakthrough is on the other side of consistency. And so to the degree that you can remain consistent, get this, in anything, consistent in anything, it will go and it will connect and affect the rest on every part of your life. So you can see breakthroughs and multiplied areas of your life. And so we're excited. We're excited about it. Listen, if you have a praise report, if you have a prayer request and or a praise report, please place it in the comments. If you have a prayer request, no matter where you are, whether you're on IG or you're on Facebook, we've got somebody that's right there. They're going to pray with you right now. We don't believe in this pray later thing. Carry it with us. We believe in praying right now. So if you have a prayer request, please go ahead and place it in the comments. One of the people that I've trained, listen, I'm telling you, 13 weeks, and some of those that have been with us for all of these weeks now know how to respond immediately to your prayer. Now, if you have one of those personal prayers, something that you believe is a little private, there will be a link there in our Facebook group. For those of you that are on IG and the phone call, please make sure that you send your prayer requests and please place praise reports as well. Send those to admin@amazingchurch.com. But if you have a prayer request, those of you that are there, click on the link and you can fill it out. And then I myself or someone from my staff will send you back an email with faith-filled instructions. We believe that every answer is found in the Word of God. I'm telling you, are you ready this morning? Let's get this party going. Let's get it going, all right? This morning, your inspiration is there. Oh, I'm sorry. I do this. I'm sorry, y'all. If you're in a watch party, those of you that are in watch parties, I want you to know that the person that's hosting the watch party loved you so much that they wanted to interact with you directly and immediately. And so, would you please give God praise for those that are hosting the watch party, but those of you that are in it, give that person that's hosting the party for you a round of applause. Come on, God bless you. Glad that you're there. Listen, those of you that are hosting, make sure you interact with your guests. We love you, and we want you to know that we appreciate you. I want to say this today, whatever church you're representing, whatever ministry you're representing, thank you so much for joining and connecting with us. This is a kingdom assignment, too big for one group to carry, too big for us, but we know that we are on assignment and doing it. So those of you from whatever city and state that you're from, whatever church, whatever pastor, whatever ministry, whatever you're leading, I'm honored that you're here. Trust me, I'm honored that you're here. Thank you so much. And let's do what we do to impact the kingdom of heaven and expanding it together, because this is the church. This is the tribe that he said that the kingdom of hell cannot prevail against. All right, those of you, your inspiration this morning, are you ready? And those of you that are new, thank y'all for joining. If your person you know has invited you, you see them on the wall, go ahead and tell them, man, I'm glad that I'm on the wall with you. On the wall, for those of you, on the wall is as if we were in the city of Jerusalem itself. We're on the wall. And as of last night, I got another wall, y'all. As if we were rebuilding the wall that was destroyed and torn down in the days of Nehemiah. And Nehemiah got them, and they were praying or believing God, construction in one hand, and they had a weapon in the other hand. We're on the wall. We're holding up the wall against all the attacks of the enemy, all the attacks from those around. You got to stay strong. We are on the wall. So we place our prayer requests on the wall. We put everything there in the wall. Are y'all ready? Come on. Your inspiration this morning, that's you on the wall. Come on the wall, y'all. If you're on the wall, say, I'm on the wall this morning. Send them up. Listen, my mama's on the wall every morning. I'm telling you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Let's go. I was going too fast there. Y'all got a whole nother minute, but we're going to go ahead and go because our inspiration this morning may be a little lengthy. All right, so your inspiration this morning is coming out of 1 Corinthians. Y'all ready? 1 Corinthians, come on. 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. I know y'all love 1 Corinthians 15. There's so many nuggets in there, so many inspirational moments in there. But we're going to go all the way down to the end, and 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, in verse number 58. Come on, give it to him. Come on, send up the hearts. Those of you that are new, we send up hearts before we read it because we give God glory in advance. Glory in advance. So that reads, y'all ready? It reads, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Let me read it again. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. That your labor is not in vain in the Lord. All right, so you got to see this. You got to read it. Therefore, there means read everything before this. Go read before this. Read the entire chapter of 1 Corinthians 15. All right, this is your devotion. We're doing this together. Dynamic devotion. We participate together. So it says, therefore, read everything before, be steadfast. That word steadfast, be firmly settled. Now he goes, he's teaching this after he talked about death. So he's saying, with the impending death, what you're doing, know this. Don't be shaken. Don't be shaken. My beloved brethren, he's saying, those of you that already believe and those that are doing the work, be steadfast, be firmly settled. This is somebody's talking to your heart. Then it says, be firmly settled, be immovable. Don't move from this place, this place or this spiritual occupation. Don't move from this. First of all, settle in your heart and don't move from this spiritual realm. Don't move from this. Be steadfast and immovable. And then it says, then always be abounding, meaning that now physically, all right, I got your heart, I got your soul, I got your spirit. Now he's saying physically, what I want you to do is make sure that you're always abounding. This word abounding means super abundantly, superfluous. Do over and above, exceedingly. All right, so he's saying over and above, provide over and above, abundantly. This steadfast and move always about in the work of the Lord. The work of the Lord. What is the work of the Lord? The work of the Lord is not simply loving the Lord. The work of the Lord is not simply coming and worshiping and giving him glory. The work of the Lord is sharing the gospel. The work of the Lord is expanding the kingdom. The work of the Lord is healing the sick. The work of the Lord is raising the dead. Raising the dead. The work of the Lord is having full confidence that the Lord God can, will, and is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all. Now listen, I'm telling you, that's what he's saying to do. Knowing, he says, confidently knowing this, that your labor, that the work that you put forth is not empty work. All right, so what is Paul saying? Paul is saying this. Here's your motivation. Come on, here's your motivation. What is Paul saying? Paul is saying, fellow brethren, be firmly settled and don't move from this place. And go all in. Come on, write that. Put that in the comments. Come on, say it. I'm going all in. I'm going all in. Let it be known. Go all in for the work of the Lord and then some. I'm going all in and then some. Go all in for the work of the Lord and then some, because this is not empty, wasted work. This is not empty, wasted work. Come on. So if that's your inspiration, you got it. If this is your motivation, let's give you your app. Here's your app. Today, settle in your heart and give yourself fully to the work of the Lord. Come on. Settle it in your heart that you... Listen, I'm a kingdom person. It's settled. This is what it is. Nothing else. Today, settle in your heart to give yourself fully to this kingdom work. Come on, give him glory for it. That's your inspiration, guys. That's your motivation. Come on. You got the application. Come on, all in on today. Make sure that you stick with this thing. That's what we're doing. That's your inspiration. That's your motivation. You got the application. Let's give him glory for it as we get prepared to pray this morning. Let somebody know that I believe in you. Tell them on the wall, I believe in you fully. Come on, Pastor P, Pop. That's it, Pop. Fully. Give yourself fully. Don't half do it. Don't give a little bit. Don't reserve something back. Be careful. Oh, I hear something. Some of you have a lot of influence. Can I talk to you? Some of you have a lot of influence, and you believe that you've given yourself fully to the work of the Lord. And the truth is that you may fully love the Lord, but your compromising actions is causing someone else to fall or to go astray. Be very careful with your presentation of what the work of the Lord is, because what you're doing is you're discipling in every work, you're discipling other people in the work of the Lord. All right, I love you. I want to make sure that you got it. I want to make sure you got it before we go into prayer. Are y'all ready to go into prayer this morning? Let's give God everything we got. Are you ready to pray this morning? Because this thing has to have prayer. So we enter in with adoration. Can you adore him? Come on, no matter where you are, no matter what you're on, whether you're on IG, whether you're on Facebook, whether you're on the call, whether you're watching a replay, whether this is on YouTube, let's go ahead and adore him. Father, we love you. Father, we bless you. We thank you this morning. We glorify your name. You're worthy of all the praise, of all the glory. We love you this morning. We thank you for being God. We thank you for being who you are. You are the great God. You're the great I am. You are the Olam. We love you, oh God. We thank you. We love and we serve a God who sees us. You're alive, God. And we give you praise. We give you glory for you being alive. We thank you, Lord God, for all that you have done, all that you will do. You're the great I am, God. There is none beside you. There was none that was going to come after you anyway. There was none that went before you that can declare it. And there is none that can stand beside you, God. Your wondrous works, your marvelous acts. Oh, God, we bless your name this morning. We give you glory this morning. We thank you. You're a mighty God. You're an awesome God. You're great and greatly to be praised. You, God, are the one who deserves all the honor, all the glory, all the adoration, all the praise. And we honor you this morning. We bless you this morning. We woke up this morning with the intent to give you glory. We woke up this morning with the intent to give you all that we have. We, God, acknowledge you as being the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord God, strong and mighty. The Lord God, mighty in battle. You are God, our banner. You are God, our shield. You are Jehovah Rapha, our healer. You are our provider, Jireh. You, God, are our peace, Shalom. And we give you glory this morning. We acknowledge your names because your word says that your name is a strong tower and the righteous can run in and are safe. So God, we thank you that because of the work on the cross that we have become righteous by receiving Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And therefore, God, we are righteous and we can run into your names and have an expectation that you're going to perform, that you're going to do, that your hand is not slack, that you're not too far from us, that we cannot be reached. We love you. We praise your name, God. Our confidence is in you. It has great recompense of reward. We, God, believe that you are and that you are a rewarder of them that diligently seek you. We thank you this morning. We bless you this morning, God. We thank you for being our strength this morning. We thank you for being our hope this morning. We thank you for being our peace this morning. We thank you, God, for being our joy. Today is the day that you have made. We choose to rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you, Lord, for being our joy. Thank you, Lord, for being our joy. Somebody got to get that. Thank you for being our joy this morning. When the enemy would rush in like a flood, God, you lift up a standard against it. When the enemy would try to depress us and make us depressed, you lift up a standard against it. When the enemy would try to get us to be full of anxiety, we thank you, Lord God, that you are giving us peace and you're giving us the peace that passes all understanding and that it guards our heart and our mind. We thank you, Lord God, for being our God, for being on the scene, for not being a God that has to show up, but being a God that's already present. Thank you for being a God that has not go and get something out of the trunk, huh? Go and get something out of the house, huh? Going to get something somewhere else, but being a God that's all powerful right now, in this moment, in this place, in every situation, God, every circumstance, every problem that's been presented. We know, God, that you are answering our prayers, that you hear us and that you will answer us and that you will show us great and mighty things. Oh God, our God. Oh God, our King. Oh God, the Almighty, the matchless one, the priceless one, the God of all gods. We love you this morning. We praise you this morning. We, God, if we had the opportunity to praise you with something else that's greater than what we got right now, we would do it. But God, we give you everything we got. We give you praise in every area we have. We give you glory in every moment, God. And so this morning, God, we acknowledge you. This morning, God, we adore you. This morning, God, we love you. This morning, God, you're the only hope we have. Our hope is in you. Our hope is in you, God. You're the only hope we know. Our hope is in you, God. Our faith is in you, God, that you're able able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we can ask, above all that we can think, above all that we can imagine. Right now, God, we ask that you forgive us for all of our sin, God. Sin that we committed, sin that we overlooked, sin, God, of apathy, sin of lethargy, sin of procrastination, sin of lying, sin, God, of cursing, sin of innuendos that are negative towards brothers and sisters and others. Sin of negative innuendos towards brothers and sisters and others. Forgive us for the sin of gossiping. God, sin that we, God, have been desensitized by here in the earth and realm. We have been desensitized, God. Raise up our holiness meter right now in the name of the Lord Jesus so that we won't become dishonorable people, dishonoring other people with our words, with our mouths, with our actions. Hallelujah. God, we ask that you take out an unforgiving spirit, the sin of unforgiveness. Remove it from us now. If there's anything in us, God, search us, oh God. See if there's any wicked thing in us, God. Take it out right now and help us, God, to remove it. Some things like offense, God, is a personal surgery. So help us, God, to remove offense out of our lives. Help us to not run away, God, from things that cause us to be hard. Things that cause us, God, to think that it's hard, but to move in the direction of the things that we don't want to do, that we know, God, are critical for our righteousness and our immovability. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we know, God, that you have concern for us and that you love us. And so this morning, we thank you that we have the things that we have petitioned you, especially in the area of your forgiveness. Your word says that you will forgive us and that you will remember it no more. Your word says that when we come to you, God, and we expect to receive the deliverance, because God, we have humbled ourselves before you. We enter in this morning with this as the sentiment of our heart. We want to please you, God, with everything in us. We want to please you, God, with our lives on today. And so, God, because of that, we thank you that we have the petitions that we have asked of you, because you hear us, God, and you respond to us and you love us. If you know that you just received it, give him praise. Before we go any further, give him glory. This is your praise God moment. This is the time where you wake up your neighbors. This is the time where you wake up everybody in the house. This is the time where you stop on your bike ride. Stop Marvin Barnes on your bike ride. Get off and give God praise. Stop Pastor Lomax on your bike ride and give God praise. Come on, stop your running. This is when you're jogging. Come on, Dan Durbin, stop jogging. Stop running right now and just wave your hand. Give God praise. I don't mean to mess up your time, but I know, y'all, you need to mess up this moment and stop doing what you're regularly doing. Blow your horn. Give him praise. Come on, give him glory. He inhabits the praises of his people. Somebody give him thanks this morning. He's worthy of it all. We praise you. We magnify you. We love you, God. We thank you for all you've done, all you're doing. We thank you for where we are now. The situation. Come on, the situation could be real different, God. Yes, God, thank you for being everything that we've called out. Thank you for moving like you move. God, thank you for shaking up things like you're shaking. Thank you, God, for putting us in position in this place, in this moment, in this time, in this hour. You knew what was going to happen in the earth. Nothing is taking you by surprise. And we thank you, Lord God, that you saw fit, that you thought that we were able. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, that you would even consider us, God, in this situation, that you would consider us in this moment to intercede, to pray, to believe, God, to declare in the name of the Lord Jesus, in this moment, in this hour, in this time, you placed us here. God, we glorify you. God, we magnify you. Your love towards us, God, is unyielding. Your love towards us is unstoppable. Your love towards us is unconditional. Your love towards us, God, is unsurpassed. And so, God, we thank you for your love towards us. We praise you. We give you glory. We give you thanks. Come on. Hallelujah. And in this moment, Lord, your God, your word says for us to be anxious for nothing, but everything in prayer through supplication to make our requests known unto you. We know, God, that your word is true and that all the promises are yes and amen in Christ Jesus. And so we're in Christ Jesus and we're praying and we're talking to you now, God, believing that you're doing exactly what you said. And so, God, we petition, we intercede. This is the greatest representation of you, Lord Jesus, that we can be in the earth, and that is interceding on behalf of others, having compassion on others. And so in this moment, this time, this morning, we're asking, God, that you would heal those that are in their sick situations, whatever they are. We're asking, God, that those that are in deathly situations, death, we're talking to you, and we're going to talk to you every single day. For those whose time is not now, stay your hand, be removed. Go to where you're supposed to go. Fulfill your assignment, but this is not the place. Whether it be human error or whether it be the attack of Satan, we bind it now in the name of the Lord Jesus. God, we thank you, Lord God. Your word says that we shall lay hands upon the sick and they shall recover. Your word also gives us principle that we can send your word and your word will heal the sick. And so, God, we send your word. Rapha, we send your word, your healing word. All manner of sickness and disease is brought to you. You're no respecter of persons. You heal all of them. You're able to heal all of these. Now, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we're holding on. We're believing. And we have a full confidence in you, God, that you're going to do it, Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray. We ask, God, that perseverance be the children's bread on today, that they're able to stand in the midst of the wickedness, unmovable, always abounding, continuing the work and extending the work. We ask, God, that you give wisdom to doctors, wisdom to nurses, wisdom to people, God, wisdom to those that are reporting news and information, wisdom, Father God, and compassion to those that are in decision-making positions, those that are in political positions. We know, God, that all power in the earth is given by you. So, Lord, we understand that they can pervert the power that was given to them. We ask, God, that you will aright, that you would fix their mind, that you would make straight, that you would clear and cleanse, God, their consciousness, as we ask that you would cleanse and clear ours, do the same in theirs, so that they can make those decisions, God, as kings and priests, as those in authority, those that have the authority, that they would change their hearts and have compassion for the people and not a desire for power or filthy lucre. In the name of the Lord Jesus, filthy money. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we ask, God, that they would make decisions. Those that are in laboratories, that you would give wisdom and inventions and witty ideas and thought processes, God, that all the things that needed to come back to their memory, that you would bring it back to their memory. Father, in Jesus' name, I ask for those that are attending and those that are coming in the hospitals with undiagnosed issues, God, that you would give those doctors and those nurses and those practitioners and those that are looking at situations, give them the memories in their mind to remember, so that there will be nothing that comes in, God, that they will walk away with no treatment, no understanding. God, we declare that healing is the children's bread, that you would heal, God. If nobody else, if no doctor, no research, no laboratory, no company, no thought process works, we know that you, God, that you work. We know that you, God, that you can heal, that we know that you can provide a miracle. So provide miracles now in the name of the Lord Jesus in every area of our lives and in the lives of those that we're interceding for now. We're asking, God, in Jesus' mighty name, that you would connect to the medical field and that they will have an overwhelming sense of your power and anointing. That, God, that you would put power and anointing, healing power in the hands of those that are attending others, God, and strengthen them. Your word says that those that refresh others will be refreshed themselves. Refresh them now, God. Make provision for them now, God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we are asking, God, that you give them an oversupply now. In the name of the Lord Jesus, an oversupply of peace, an oversupply of comfort. Holy Spirit, move in and comfort those that are dealing with death on a daily basis. Comfort those that do not have or were not prepared for this moment, that you would strengthen them in this moment like never before. In the name of the Lord Jesus, God, we ask now that you would strengthen and comfort our police officers and law enforcement throughout the entire country and all over the world. We're asking that you would comfort them and strengthen them, God, that they would not cower back and become cowards, God, that they will stand firm, God, and understand and move forward in every area, but do it on behalf of what they have said, God, that they are doing it for, and that is serving and protecting the people. We thank you, Lord God, that investigations will prove that the truth shall come forward, that there shall be no more hanging of things over the heads of people that do not and should not deserve it. We pray now, God, and intercede on behalf of all nations and all races, and in particular, God, the race race of chocolate-covered people all over the world, God, because this kind of attack is all over the world and not relegated to one country and one nation, but it is in every country, from Israel to Africa, all the way here, God, in the United States, from Canada and down in Mexico, God, all over in South America, that these people, God, I pray in Jesus' name, the people that I'm a part of, chocolate-covered folk, God, that you would strengthen, that you would redeem, that you would restore, God, that you would cover and protect, and God, that they would have more than just enough strength and power to overcome. And God, I pray that you would put compassion in the hearts of the African-American, African chocolate-covered people all over the world, that they would have compassion on their brothers and sisters in the places, God, where they may not have all of the understanding or information. That, Lord, we will intercede now on behalf of people of all nations, of all other races, because, God, there is love for you in every color, love for you in every nation, love for you in every race of people, and we declare that we are kingdom people, that we're not affiliated more with a nation, we're not affiliated more with a color of skin, we're not affiliated more with anything in the earth than we are with you, than a gender, and in Jesus' name, we're affiliated with the kingdom of God, and we're king's kids, we're the children of the Most High God, and we are one family, we are one race, the Christ race, we are the ones, the Christian race, we are believers, the race of the people of the way. We declare in Jesus' name that our unity, the reason we are declaring this morning is because you said, God, that you call it beautiful, how beautiful it is when brothers dwell together in unity. It is like the dew that pours down off Mount Hermon, that goes down even Aaron's beard, even unto the hem. And we know, God, that healing is in the hem. May we humble ourselves and become down by the hem kind of people. And God, as we touch the hem of your garment, we declare that we're healed in our minds, we're healed in our bodies, we're healed in our soul and in our spirits. And God, that we shall be those that shall carry this healing now in the name of the Lord Jesus. And we give you thanks, and we give you praise, and we give you glory, and we give you honor, and we magnify your name. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we declare it to be so. In his name, we pray. Somebody shout hallelujah. Come on. Give him glory for it this morning. Give him thanks for it this morning. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. That's what we do, y'all. That's how we do it. He says, stand fast. Steadfast, unmovable, immovable, always, always continually abounding in the work of the Lord. Listen, I love y'all. Thank y'all for joining the Everyday Until Dynamic Devotion and Prayer, where all of God's children come together. All of God's children, whether they are red, yellow, black, or white, we are all precious in his sight. Y'all know the song, right? I'm telling you, that's powerful. The Lord placed that on my heart to pray it in that manner, where we're interceding on behalf of those that need to have better understanding, and that we as a race of people, especially those that are chocolate covered, that we intercede on behalf of others, and then that we who call ourselves children of the Most High God, that we understand that we're more affiliated with the kingdom than we are the color of our skin, that we're more affiliated with the kingdom of God than we are the nation that we're a part of, that we're more affiliated with the kingdom of God than we are even our genders. Do you understand that? All of those things do matter, because God calls them beautiful. He made no mistake when he created anybody. He didn't make any mistake when he placed you in any family. Listen, I promise you, you say, man, things was way too tough, way too crazy. The will of the person is that will. God's given you free will and giving you dominion in the earth, but that doesn't mean that the Father has made a mistake. Many of us have endured in tough times and tough things, but you've overcome by the power of someone's testimony and the blood of the Lamb, and we got to believe that other people will be able to overcome as well. And so when we walk and we stand as King's kids, we don't get caught up in the politics, and we don't get caught up in the racial tensions. You don't get caught up. Now, we're not ignorant of it. We don't do that. That the scripture is clear that we have to be about justice, and especially when there's injustice. That's the reason why Jesus came in the first place. So you can't be a believer and try to ignore that and go, I'm just going to pray. No, you got to do more than prayer. Prayer without works, faith without works, rather, is dead. Prayer without action is just hollering. All right? So I want y'all to go with that today. Why? Because when you look at that scripture that we studied on today, that inspiration, immovable, steadfast, unmovable, always abounding, over all in, doing the work of the Lord, that's what you need to do. All right? So I love you. We'll meet you back here tomorrow morning. The Lord say the same at 8 a.m. Central Standard Time for the Everyday Until Dynamic Devotion and Prayer. Call us. I love you. I appreciate you. Y'all know that. Thank y'all for joining in this morning. Y'all are faithful. May God richly bless and keep you on today. Let me bless y'all. I just sense that in my spirit before I let everybody go. May the Lord God richly bless and keep you on today. May He meet every request with heaven's best. May there be nothing missing, nothing broken, and no lack in your life. May you always be provided the bread of life and bread to eat. May your seeds come back to you with interest in the name of the Lord Jesus as you sow of your time, your talent, and your treasure, that the kingdom of God is expanded. And as a result, the Lord has already promised that He will supply seed to the sower and that He will give you all sufficiency in all things. Hallelujah! Receive that today as you go all in for the Lord, as you go all in for God today, that He will provide all sufficiency in everything that you do. Have an expectation that He is going to provide, that He is going to show up in every place of your need, whether it be some tangible need, whether it be a spiritual need, or whether it be an emotional need. Our God can, He will, and He's able. All right, I love y'all. Have a great day. Be blessed. Call us. Thank y'all. IG, love y'all. Appreciate y'all for everything that you've done today, being faithful. I love it. I love it. Stay here. Let's get folk here. I praise God for you. Love you. I'm honored to be a part of what you're doing. Be blessed. All right, those of you that are on Facebook, I love y'all. Y'all know that. I promise you. I appreciate you. Let's keep this thing going. We'll see you tomorrow morning. The Lord say the same. Be blessed. Have a great day.